This is a press release by the Church of Ceylon on the visit of His Grace, Most Reverend and Right Honorable Justin Welby, the Archbishop of Canterbury. Ladies and gentlemen of the media, thank you for your presence at this briefing on the visit of His Grace, the Most Reverend and Right Honorable Justin Welby, the Archbishop of Canterbury, to Sri Lanka. He will be accompanied by his wife, Caroline, the Right Reverend Anthony Pogo, the Archbishop of Canterbury's advisor on Anglican Communion Affairs, and his Chief of Staff, Canon David Porter. The Archbishop of Canterbury is the spiritual head of the worldwide Anglican Communion, which has about 85 million members spread over more than 105 countries, and is one of the largest and most widespread Christian denomination. Anglicans traces their origin to the 16th century, when the Church in England declared freedom from the Roman Catholic Church. The office of the Archbishop of Canterbury, however, goes back 1,400 years. Archbishop Welby came to the church after having worked for 11 years in the oil industry, of which several years in Paris for the French oil giant Elf. He felt led to the ministry, and he came to be trained and was ordained as a priest in the year 1989. And he was consecrated the Bishop of Durham in the year 2011. A year later, in November 2012, he was elected the 105th Archbishop of Canterbury. Archbishop Welby was educated at Eton College and Trinity College, Cambridge, and is a member of the House of Lords since 2011 by virtue of office, and is also a member of the Privy Council. He has served as a member of the Parliamentary Commission on Banking Standards and was invited by the UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres to serve on a high-level advisory board on mediation. In the United Kingdom Order of Precedence, he ranks immediately after the royal family. Archbishop Justin Welby is married to Caroline and have five children, and one of his daughters having died in a motor accident several years ago. He is the author of a number of books on ethics, business, and finance. Archbishop Welby is the Metropolitan of the Anglican Church in Sri Lanka, the Church of Ceylon. The Anglican Church is made up of 40 fully independent national provinces, each headed by an archbishop. Sri Lanka, having only two Anglican dioceses, Colombo and Kurunagala, does not have an archbishop and is known as an extra-provincial church. Hence, although the Church of Ceylon has been incorporated by an Act of Parliament and is governed by its own constitution, the archbishop exercises certain metropolitical functions. In the Anglican tradition, the Archbishop of Canterbury is considered only as the first among equals, primus inter pares, and not as an absolute help. The Church of Ceylon has been present in Sri Lanka from early British times. Colonial chaplains were followed by missionaries of the CMS and SPG, who established mission stations and schools in Baddegama, Kote, Jaffna, and Kandy in the early 19th century, followed by many other schools at different levels. Today, the church operates 11 boys and girls schools, 2 institutions for the visually and hearing impaired children, 5 homes for elders, and 45 preschools for less privileged children, and several other medical and educational centers. The church is present in almost all districts of Sri Lanka. Archbishop Welby's short visit to Sri Lanka, his first, is primarily an act of solidarity with the Christian church here and the nation following their Easter Day bombings. He will visit St. Sebastian's Church, Katuwapitiya, accompanied by His Eminence Malcolm Cardinal Ranjit, to offer prayers. In Colombo, he will meet with religious leaders and members of the Congress of Religions, and also officiate at a service at the Cathedral of Christ the Living Savior. On Friday, the 30th of August, the Archbishop and his delegation will travel to Kandy and Kurunagala. He will make a courtesy call on the Mahanayakas of Asgiriya and Malvatta chapters, and is also scheduled to visit the Dalada Maligawa. He will proceed to Kurunagala to hold a service at the Cathedral of Christ the King and to meet and greet Anglicans of the Diocese of Kurunagala. He is also expected to call on His Excellency, the President, the Honorable Prime Minister, and the Honorable Leader of the Opposition. He will leave Colombo on the 31st of August. I am Bishop Diloraj Ranjit Kanagasabe, the presiding bishop of the Church of Ceylon, and also the bishop of the Diocese of Colombo.
His Grace, the Most Reverend and Right Honorable Justin Welby, will visit Sri Lanka from the 29th to the 31st of August 2019. I will outline some of the key places that he would be visiting during his solidarity visit to Sri Lanka. He arrives on the morning of August 29th, and after a brief meeting at the VVIP lounge at the Bandaranaike International Airport, he will travel to St. Sebastian's Church in Katuwapitiya. At St. Sebastian's Church in Katuwapitiya, he will be welcomed by His Eminence Malcolm Cardinal Ranjit, Archbishop of Colombo. He will meet with the families of the people who were killed and injured in the terrorist attack on Easter Day. Thereafter, In the afternoon, he will meet the Honorable Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe at Temple Trees. After the meeting with the Prime Minister, he will travel to meet the opposition leader, Honorable Mahinda Rajapaksa. After the meeting with the opposition leader, he will travel to the diocesan premises and he will be led by the band of St. Thomas's Prep School Kolpiti from the entrance to the diocesan premises to the diocesan chambers. He will then be meeting with the interfaith leaders and heads of all churches. The Archbishop, a Buddhist leader, a Hindu and Islam leader, will speak and make statements to the nation. He will then be led by the band of Bishop's College, Colombo, from the diocesan chambers to the Cathedral of Christ the Living Savior, and the commencement of the Holy Eucharist service will then commence at the Cathedral of Christ the Living Savior. We will give a live feed, and if any television station wants to pick, they could do so during the cathedral service. After the service, he will then move to the Bandaranaike International Conference Hall for dinner and will meet His Excellency President Maithripala Sirisena later on 29th evening. On Friday the 30th, the Archbishop will travel to the diocesan premises and will plant a tree to signify his visit to Sri Lanka. He will then travel to Kandy and will be met by the Diyavadana Nilame at the temple of the Tooth Relic in Kandy. From there, the Archbishop and the delegation will travel to meet the chief prelate of the Malvatta chapter and the Asgiriya chapter, after which they will travel to Theological College of Lanka in Pilimitalava. After the visit to Theological College Lanka, he will then travel to Kurunegala and will participate in a Holy Eucharist service at the Cathedral of Christ the King, Kurunegala. After the conclusion of the service, he will travel back to Colombo and will join in a private dinner at the Bishop's House in Colombo. On Saturday 31st, the British High Commissioner will host a breakfast, and after breakfast, the Archbishop and his delegation will leave to the Bandaranaike International Airport and depart from Sri Lanka. Arun Gamalapge, Provincial Secretary, Church of Ceylon. Thank you.
ඇත්තම මේක මේ අපි කිසිම දේශපාලන පක්ෂයක් හම්බ වෙන්නේ නැහැ. අපි හම්බ වෙන්නේ අගමැතිතුමාවයි ජනාධිපතිතුමාවයි පක්ෂ නායකයි. පක්ෂපාත ભેද වලින් කිසි කෙනෙක් හම්බ වෙන්නේ නැහැ. රටේ නායකයන් විතරයි හම්බ වෙන්නේ.
And also because it's a
solidarity. මේක මේ මේක නිල සංචාරයක් නෙමෙයි.
ඒක solidarity විශ්ල එකක් නේ අර තුවාල වෙච්ච අයව හම්බෙලා කතා කරලා ඒගොල්ලන් වෙනුවෙන් යාඥා කරලා යන තමයි උන්වහන්සේ මේ ඇත්තන පැමිණෙන්නේ. ඉතින් දේශපාලකයන් වාදය හැම වෙලද ගියාම දැන් පොලිටික්ස් සමේ කතා වෙන්න කරන්න වෙන්නේ වෙලාවෙදී.
තාත්තතුමා කියනවා බාස්ක ප්‍රහාරය සම්බන්ධයෙන් පරීක්ෂණයක් නෑ කියන එක. මේ ඒ සම්බන්ධයෙන් ගියාම රජයට අවධානයක් ලක් කරන්න අපහසුතාවය වෙනවාද
මේ කියන්නේ දැන් මේකේ බලාපොරොත්තු වෙන විශේෂයෙන්ම අර ඒ සුහදත්වය සහ ඒගොල්ලොත් එක්ක ඉන්නවයි කියන එක තහවුරු කරන්න. ඒ අය අය බලන්න විතරක් නෙමෙයි එතකොට ක්‍රිස්තියානි ඔක්කොමත් එක්ක සහ ඒ වගේම අපේ රටේ ජනතාවත් එක්ක සහෝදරත්වයේ තහවුරු කරගන්න. ඒ ඇත්ත එක්ක ඉන්නවා කියලා ජනතාවක් කියන්නේ. ක්‍රිස්තියානි විතරක් නෙමෙයි. ඒ ඇත්ත එක්ක ඉන්නවා කියන්නේ. ඇත්තම දැන් රදු ගුරුවරු දෙන්න තමයි ආර්දනාව කරේ. අපි ආර්දනා කරලා තිබුණා එතුමා ළඟදී නැහැ කියලා කිව්වෙ නුත් එතුමා ඉන්දියාවට එන්න තිබුණා. ඒත් එක්ක තමයි මෙහෙට එනවා කියලා එතුමා තීරණය කළේ. ඇත්තම දවස් භාගයකට අපි තමයි කියලා දවස් දෙකමාරකට පික් කරගත්තා.
අපේ ප්‍රධාන විෂයතුමා නිසා අපි යෝජනාවක් කරා මෙතන පැමිණලා යන්නට කියලා. ඒක අපිටත් හොඳයි, ජනතාවටත් හොඳයි, තුවාල වෙච්ච ක්‍රිස්තියානි අයටත් හොඳයි කියලා අපි හිතුවා. රටටත් හොඳයි.
ඒක දැන් මෙතුමාගේ පැමිණීමෙන් විශේෂයෙන්ම වෙන්නේ රටවල් 165ක අපේ සභාව තියෙනවා. දැන් එන අවුරුද්ද තියෙනවා ඔක්කොම බිෂප් එකතු වෙනවා. එතකොට ඇත්තෙන්ම අපේ රටේ සම්බන්ධව ජාත්‍යන්තර මතයක් ඇති කරන්න, පැහැදීමක් ඇති කරන්න මේක ඉවහල් වෙන ඉඳ තමයි අපි ගොඩක් කල්පනා
කරන්නේ.
ඇත්තෙම දැන් සාධාරණ හිටියොන කියන එක ඉතින් එන්න ඕනනේ සාධාරණ හිටියට.
සමහර වෙලට කතා කරනකොට ඒ දේවල් ඇති වෙන්නට පුළුවන්. ජනපති එක්ක මේ මේ අපේ අගමැතිතුමාත් එක්ක මම හිතනවා ඒ වෙලාවේදී උන්වහන්සේ සමහර වෙලාවට ප්‍රශ්න අහන්නට පුළුවන් ඒ දේවල් ගැන අපිට කියන්න
බැහැ.
අපි දන්නේ මොන ඉතින් කතා කරලා යන්නේ කියලා. ඉතින් ඒක අපිට මෙතන ඉඳලා කියන්න බැහැ. මෙහෙම මේක මේ ගැන තමයි කතා කරන්න යන්නේ කියලා. It can become part of a conversation, but there's no guarantee that this will be the subject. Of course, it is regarding solidarity. We are with you.
That is not the main purpose of this visit.
Yeah, ekathama.
Eke mukhya paramarthaya ekane me.